Her name was Lorraine. She was this brown-skinned girl, slightly taller than me, with a public school accent where I thought her voice would be. We must have been about 14 and I thought she was so pretty. She kissed me, or maybe I kissed her. I don't quite remember. One moment we were throwing smiles across the darkness of this school dance, and the next we were up close, breathing each other like air, slaves to these spiraling, dizzying rhythms, trying to negotiate that clumsy enamel clash of teeth against teeth. In that moment, I forgot everything. Forgot the heavily weighted glares of the Gallus boys that brought me here to see me do it like I was supposed to. Forgot the challenge of proving myself this rite of passage. In that moment, I surrendered everything I was thinking to the slick inquisition of her tongue dancing against mine. Eyes closed and submerged, heart beating on tongue tip like something I really wanted to say but had forgotten how to form the words for. And at the end of the night, when the lights came up, pulling us apart with that strange sense of disorientation as we blinked ourselves back into real time, I realized I didn't have a pen or a piece of paper on which to note down those necessary details like I'd been told. So I tied her name and number to the back of this sweet, delicate memory as she disappeared into the parting crowd. I must have smiled my way home that night, deaf to the disses and jibes of the boys I left with. I must have chanted her name and number under my breath like a prayer or mantra to prove she'd actually happened to me. And I never saw her again.